Governor-elect Scott Walker is looking to Indiana as a model for a makeover of Wisconsin's Commerce Department because Indiana abolished its Commerce Department in favor of the public-private partnership known as the Indiana Economic Development Corporation. Its CEO is also the Indiana Secretary of Commerce. Mitch Roob joins us now from Indianapolis to give us a sense of how the job of growing jobs works in the Hoosier State. And Secretary, thanks very much for joining us.
Very nice to be with you.
Well, what is it about your Economic Development Corporation, formerly known as the Commerce Department, that states like Wisconsin should want to model after?
Well, we are singularly focused on bringing new business here to Indiana. So we spend almost no time on what folks call capacity building. There are other parts of state government that worry about workforce development or education. We are the hunter-gatherers. We go out and we hunt for companies around the country and across the world, and we bring them to Indiana. That is our singular focus.
So how is Indiana better able to attract and keep the jobs than under the direction of this Economic Development Corporation as opposed to a Commerce Department, which also is usually tasked with being the hunter-gatherers of these kinds of jobs?
Right. Well, our experience in Indiana has been that by focusing exclusively on one important piece, which is the sales and marketing of the state of Indiana, and the governor sits on our board. He is the chairman of our board. We have a group of very high-powered Indiana executives make up our board of directors, and we focus like a laser on bringing new jobs here to Indiana.
And how does
and that's all we do.
How does the private nature, this is called a public-private partnership, how does that piece, the private piece, go further toward creating jobs in Indiana?
Well, we're able to raise, we raise about $1.5 million a year from private corporations who give it to us to help pursue our goals of economic development. Taxpayers understandably would feel a bit awkward about having us host and pay for receptions in France or in Italy or in China, at which we served alcohol and some Line and Kugel's beer, by the way. But that's part of doing business. That's part of any marketing effort is the relationship development process, the social process that goes on that kind of lubricates the deal. And we don't believe that tax dollars ought to pay for that. We use our private sector funds for that.
Well, one recent headline called this a privatization model that outsources economic development. Is that a positive or a negative?
I don't think it's either. I mean, technically, many of our staff members are still government employees. So, I think the whole outsourcing thing is way overdone. It's not been an issue here in Indiana.
Now, the fact remains, though, that Indiana's unemployment rate is among the highest in the region, higher than Wisconsin's. And a man by the name of Morton Marcus, whom you know, I'm sure, former head of the Indiana Business Research Center at Indiana University, said, quote, "Over the last 5 years, Indiana largely lagged in job creation, and the agency had not made a huge difference in job creation in the state as a whole." How do you respond to that?
Well, in America, you're entitled to your opinion. Morton Marcus can have his opinion. I've not seen that particular quote by Morton. But we do, and we have been very effective in the last year in Indiana in having new jobs be created here. We're number two in the country in terms of creation of new private sector jobs. So that model's worked well for us. You know, I'm not running for Secretary of Commerce of Wisconsin. I'm ambivalent, candidly, whether your governor does or doesn't set up a different model. That's up to you, him, and the citizens up in Wisconsin. I will tell you this much, it's worked well in Indiana.
Just playing a little bit more devil's advocate, an investigative report, which I'm sure you're also familiar with out of an Indianapolis TV station, showed that 40% of the jobs announced by Indiana from 2006 to 2008 have not actually come. Is that accurate?
Well, first of all, it's not accurate. Secondly, the number about set right now, 87% of the jobs that are the deals that are active have delivered the number of jobs that they indicate would show up. Look, we've been through a terrible recession, and in Indiana and Wisconsin and America, so there are going to be some deals that don't come to fruition. But no tax incentives in Indiana are paid until after the job is created and the taxes are collected on it. I think the interesting point here, a national survey came out just today, actually, that showed Indiana number 8 in terms of transparency, and we're second in the nation in job creation. But again, this is a system that works well for Indiana. Whether it works well in Wisconsin, I can't say.
So you can't say whether or not you think that this is a model that actually could be kind of overlaid in any other state. Why would it work well in Indiana and not necessarily be a good model elsewhere?
I mean, no offense to the people of Wisconsin, but my concern isn't Wisconsin. Right? I understand Indiana. It works well in Indiana. It may or may not work well in other states. So that's up to those states if they want to experiment with it. They're welcome to use our model, and we're happy to talk to them about it. But again, that's not our concern.
Good. Well, I do hope it does work, if in fact it becomes our model. And good luck to you as well. Mitch Roob, thanks very much.
Thank you.